So the question, how do we create structures that support our event framing or batch in the PI system is answered by the module database. And we use the module database with batch in order to organize our units. What is the module database? Well, the module database is simply a hierarchical collection of modules. The modules can represent products, equipment, production lines, machinery, literally anything. And the modules contain two important aspects. One of them is aliasing, tag lookups, given common names to maybe uncommonly named tags, and properties. Properties are constants, and those are things that don't change regularly, as opposed to the tag values that do change regularly. And if we come back to our jigsaw diagram of how everything's tightly integrated, you'll remember we had our PI archives, which stores our process values, the batch database, which stores the actual batch records, and the module database is where we're at now, and this stores batch configuration. And so we're going to spend a good amount of time looking at how batches are configured. Aliasing is a process by which we assign common, more human readable names to tags that might not otherwise contain indications of what they were monitoring. Here's an example that we have of a temperature identification without using aliases. I have four reactors, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And these reactors all have temperature sensors in them. They all monitor the current temperature of the reactor, and in fact we have many temperature sensors in them at different points. Without using aliasing, I would have to know, say for example with reactor 3, that the temperature sending unit was rx:tc012.pv. Now, that probably makes sense to someone in the process control group, the instrument technician or the process control engineer. It's probably very logical, but to everybody else, they don't know what that refers to or what that means. And so figuring out what's happening in reactor 3 can be very difficult. With aliasing in the module database, I simply have to create modules for each one of my reactors. And then in each one of those modules, I can have a temperature alias. So I can build reports and displays, and I can query for data only knowing that I need reactor 3's temperature value, and I don't have to know the tag name. It'll resolve it for me. That's essentially what the alias function of the module database does in the PI system. Properties are in some ways the opposite of aliases, and that is that they contain data that doesn't change. PI tags inherently, being process values, change, and PI properties are what sometimes we refer to as constants. They're values that don't change, or if they do change, they change very infrequently. Some of the examples might be a serial number of a piece of equipment, the installation date, maybe the last maintenance date of the piece of equipment, maybe some specifications about it, like target temperature, some vibration specs, pressure specifications, safety data, things that may change over time, but they generally don't change very often. Some people use properties to store application data with custom applications, or they use them to hold SQL statements in order to connect to other databases. There are a lot of uses to PI properties, and just remember that there are aliases and properties, and aliases are tag values, and properties are constants. The module database has the ability to store what's called heading sets. A heading set is a collection of simple identifiers. We use them in order to be able to search. So if you want to search for a particular PI heading, you can do that. They do not enforce any sort of hierarchy structure. Some people have applications where headings do enforce a structure. Ours are just simply labels that are helpful in terms of searching. When people build out their module databases, many people elect to use the physical model for their module database. Here's an example. I have OSI Industries. This is just a fictional entity. And we start at the enterprise level, and we drill down to the division and department and location in sort of a physical representation of my company. So I drill down through the business units, through different departments, and then finally locations, until I get to units and equipment. And by the time I get to units and equipment, I'm usually at something that's physical, something that has aliases, which are process variables, or has properties. Properties describe something about the physical unit. Now, you don't have to use a physical model. There are many ways to describe an enterprise. Here's an example where I've got a heat exchanger, and that heat exchanger is E100. And this is the same module, but it's used in multiple locations and, or I should say, multiple branches of my organizational tree. You can see all of these start with the enterprise called High Tech Chemicals, but we have one branch that represents sites. This is somewhat of a geographical organization, so we're listing by city and then different plants with different pieces of equipment in each one of those cities. We could list by business group, and this would be a different type of organization, or we could list by regional divisions. All of these drill down to the same piece of equipment, which has the same aliases and the same properties, but they're just different ways to get there. So you can see that not only doesn't it matter how you build out your module database, but you can build it out in different ways within the same organizational structure. So it's very flexible.